talking this morning, amen. Amen. Y'all have been too quiet for me, amen. But I pray to God that God wake you up, amen. I know it's early. But a lot of things happen early, amen. A lot of things happen early, amen. Now, if you was at that job and you was at that computer, amen, you'd be all excited. They told you had a bonus when you looked at that computer, amen. Amen, piano. Amen. To God be the glory. They told me I had 25 minutes. And I believe I looked at my sermon, it was 20 minutes. But since y'all sitting down on me, I'm going to ask Pastor for 10 more minutes. Amen. Amen. If you would, please stand. Let us pray. Father God, we thank you today, and we pray that this is Resurrection Sunday, Father. We pray to God that I may decrease, that you may increase, that your word will go forth, that lives will be changed, souls will be saved, and the backslider will be reclaimed, and the believer will be encouraged. We thank you, Father, for this day. We pray this now in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. St. Luke, chapter 23. St. Luke, chapter 23. Starting with verse 12, when you find this, amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. That very day, Pilate and Herod became friends with each other. For previously they had been at enemy with each other. Then Pilate, when he had called together the chief priests, the rulers, and the people, said unto them, ye have brought this man to me as one who hath misled the people. And indeed, having examined him in your presence, I find no fault in this man concerning those things which ye have accused him of. Amen.
Amen.
You may be seated. For a few minutes, I would like to speak on the topic, innocent blood for a guilty world. Innocent blood for a guilty world. It says, that very day, Pilate and Herod became friends with each other, for previously they had been enemies with each other. So that tells us this morning that you're not the first when your enemies come at you. They may not have gotten along prior, but when it comes down to you, they team up. Amen. I guess I'm the only one. I guess I'm the only one with enemies this morning. But it's amazing that they can be at odds with each other. But when it comes down to God's people, the enemies will team up against God's people. So that's letting me know you're not the first one. So this has been going on for quite some time. Amen. There were several events that stands out before Jesus was taken to Governor Pilate. Amen. One was the institution of the Lord's Supper. The Lord's Supper says, this do in remembrance of me. We have taken the Lord's Supper, amen. It doesn't say, do this. This do in remembrance of me. And then secondly, Christ's prayer in Gethsemane. St. Luke 22 and 42 say, Father, if it's thy will, if thou be willing, remove this cup from me. Then he says, nevertheless, not my will, but thy will be done.
Hallelujah.
Do we have any the nevertheless folks in here? Amen. I just need a couple of nevertheless people to raise a hand where you are. Amen. That's saying, Father, nevertheless, not my will, but let your will be done. Father, I want this certain husband. I want this certain house. I want this certain car. I want this certain job. But nevertheless, not my will, but let your will be done. Amen. God is looking for a few nevertheless people. Amen. Amen. We find in our text that Pontius Pilate, on the second exam of Jesus, the first time in St. Luke 23, 1 through 4, it says, then the whole multitude of them arose and led him to Pilate. And they began to accuse him, saying, we find this man, perverting the nation and forbidding to pay taxes to Caesar, saying that he himself is Christ, a king. Amen. I don't know about you, but he's my king.
Amen.
Yes. Amen. Amen. He's my king. Then Pilate asked him, saying, Are you the king of the Jews? He answered him and said, it is as you say. Amen.
Amen.
It is as you say. So Pilate said to the chief priests and to the crowd, I find no fault in this man.
Hallelujah.
This was the first time he said, I find no fault in this man.
Right.
Now, I don't know about you, but I'm going to start walking in a minute because I got some faults and I got some issues. Amen. And when I walk, I feel like I'm dropping off some of those issues that I have. So excuse me when I start walking because I find myself that I have some fault, but this man, Jesus, has no fault.
That's it. That's
right. In him. In all four Gospels accounts, Pilate lobbies for Jesus to be spared for his life. Mm-hmm. In the Gospel of Matthew, Pilate washes his hands to show that he is not responsible for the execution of Jesus. The Gospel of Mark, Jesus as innocent of plotting against the Roman Empire. In the Gospel of Luke, having examined him before you and find no fault in this man, touching those things where you accuse him. And you know, when we take the Lord's Supper, as Pastor begins to service the Lord's Supper, it says that we need to examine ourselves.
Yes.
Amen. Amen. It's so easy that we can examine our husband and we can examine our wives. Amen. Amen, piano. We can examine our best friends. We can examine our co-workers. But the Bible says we need to examine.
Good work. Come on, Pastor.
See, this morning y'all looked in the mirror. You look pretty good and you look well, but sometimes you need to examine.
That's it.
I'm not talking about the inside. I'm talking about what's on the inside.
Yeah.
Amen, piano. You need to examine yourselves. I heard it before that your attitude determines your altitude.
That's it, good word.
You have that bad attitude. Amen. Examine yourself, check yourself. There are three people we would like to look at as we live on the inside of you, those things that live on the inside of you. One, we want to look at the position of Judas. Second, we want to look at the position of Pilate. Mm-hmm. And then third, we want to look at the position of Christ. Mm-hmm. Amen. Judas had been his companion along the highways of his public ministry. He had sat at the table with him. He had heard those intimate and private conversations. He had been one of those inner circle souls, amen, loyal to him, at least by confession and profession. This man was the traitor in the camp, the betrayer of our Lord from the inner circle. You know, that let you know that sometime on the inner circle, those that are closer to you, that can hurt you, amen, that will betray you, amen. Amen. We all got haters. We all have haters.
That's it.
Amen. I said it before and I'll say it again. I just wish they had some hater repellents. Amen. Where you can just. Psh. This is for the haters. Amen. His betrayed that wide circle of the Roman power. So by process of betrayal from the inner circle outward, our Lord was handed over by a member of his own disciples to the foes plotting for his own life, and by the members of his own nation to the nation without, which cared nothing for him, but wholly for themselves. As we look at Judas in that terrible picture, we see a man filled with terror, the terror of a lost soul, the sense of sin, and the dread of its issues. Not regret, not the sense of sin with desires to escape it, but the sense of sin with desire to escape the issues of it. Sometimes we just want to escape our sin. But sometimes we have to deal with the issues of our sin. Amen. Let me say that again. Sometimes you have to deal with your issues.
Yes.
As I said earlier, I know I got some issues. I got fault. What about yours?
Okay.
Are you dealing with your issues?
Right.
Amen. That is not the repentance that brings a man to God. If a man simply repents of sin by attempting to escape his issues or her issues, he knows nothing of repentance in the true sense of the word.
Uh-huh.
For the word says, all have sinned and fall short of the glory of God.
Yes.
Amen. All have sinned. Amen. I remember one time I was in a church back in Texas, and this old man, he wasn't too old, but he stood up and said, I haven't sinned in 40 years. All I can say is, Lord, have mercy. See, some of us feel like that sometimes, I think. On our good day, on our get day, we don't measure up. I don't mean to bust anybody's bubble this morning. In all the Gospels' accounts, Pilate is reluctant to condemn Jesus. As governor of Judea, Pontius Pilate faced a conflict of interest between the Roman Empire and the Sanhedrin Jewish Council. Pilate asked Jesus if he was a king of the Jews. He claimed that Jesus embraced the title, which he never did, This accusation was considered an act of treason by the Roman government, according to some sources. Pontius Pilate collaborated with the Jewish leaders who viewed Jesus' claims to power as a political threat in the process or persecution of Jesus. The false charge against Jesus was he wanted to lead an army revolt against Caesar and set up himself as king. When Pilate tried to set Jesus free, Jesus' opponents kept shouting, "If you let this man go, you're no friend of Caesar." John 19 and 12. Fearful of his position, Pilate caved in order to save his position. See, some of us too worried about our position.
On
our job at the coffee pot when they start telling those jokes about Jesus. And they know you're a believer. And they begin to talk about Jesus and all you do is sit there and smile. I guess I'm the only one. Amen. It's about time that we don't worry about our position, but we stand and take a strong stand for Jesus. It's time that we stand in faith, claiming who we are. It's time for the Christians to come out of the closet. Everybody else is coming out of the closet. It's time for the Christians to come out of the closet. Perceive us.
That's it.
When I leave here, amen, I want people to say, and I want Pastor McGinnis to preach my funeral to say, this man stood for Christ. Yeah. Nothing else matters. It's not a matter about what clothes I wear, what car I drive, what side of the neighborhood I live on. It's about standing for Christ and Christ only. Yeah. For Christ I live, for Christ I die. Concerning the man in front of him, or listen to the the clamors of those men and women who were shouting, crucifying, crucifying. He knew full well if he handed Jesus over to freedom, they would complain against him at Rome. Matthew 27 and 19 says, when he sat down on the judgment seat, his wife sent unto him, saying, have nothing to do with this just man, for I have suffered many things. I have suffered many things this day in a dream because of him. Amen. I'm going to give a shout out to the women. Amen. Brother, sometime we need to listen to our wives.
Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen. He suffered, she says, she suffered many things in a dream. The charges of the Sanhedrin against Jesus had no power before Pilate. From these three charges brought by the Jewish leaders, perverting the nation, forbidding payments to tribute to Caesar, and treason against the Roman Empire, Pilate picks on the third one, asking, are you the king of the Jews? Jesus replied, you have said. Then hearing continues, and Pilate finally asks, what is true? Then we talk about Jesus. John 3:16, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son. Whosoever believes in him shall not perish, but have everlasting life.
Amen.
Amen. We have everlasting life in Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
We have everlasting life in Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
We shall have everlasting life in Jesus. And the songwriter penned, no greater love. No greater love. Jesus went to Calvary to save a wretch like you and me. That's love. That's love. They hung him high. They stretched him wide. He hung his head for you and me. He died. That's love.
That's
love.
That's it.
That's not how the story ends. 3 days later, he rose again. That's love. That's love. That's love. No greater love. Jesus went to Calvary to save a wretch like you and me. That's love. That's love. They hung him high. They stretched him wide. He hung his head. For you and me, he died. That's love. That's love. That's not how the story ends. 3 days later, he rose again. That's love. That's love. Amen. Are you pursuing God with a greater heart? Are you pursuing God this day? Are you pursuing God with a greater love? Romans 3, 23, 24. For all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. But being justified freely by his grace through the redemption that is in Christ Jesus. That's love. That's love. I've been redeemed. I've been redeemed. You've been redeemed. You've been redeemed. You've been redeemed. No matter what you've been through, no matter what you're in, Christ came and died for you. That's love. That's love. No greater love than a man will lay down his life for a friend. That's love. They hung him high. They stretched him wide. For you he died. That's love. The cross is empty. The cross is bare. The tomb is empty. That's love. That's love. Are you pursuing God? Are you pursuing God? Are you walking in faith? Hebrews 11 and 6. But without faith, it's impossible to please him.
Yeah.
For who comes to God must believe that he is, and that he is a rewarder for those who diligently seek him.
Yeah.
Are you seeking God this morning?
Yeah.
Are Are you seeking God this morning? What are you seeking? Don't seek him on the cross because the cross is bare. Seek him in your heart. Seek him in your heart. You got to know Christ for yourself. Grandma can't do it. Grandpa can't do it. You have to have a relationship with God all by yourself. That's love. So God, have faith. Stand in faith. Walk in faith. Know that God loves you. Innocent blood. Because you are guilty. You were guilty of sin. But Christ died for you. He died for you. He died for you. But he rose with all power. All power. All power. In his hands. So then faith coming by hearing. So faith comes by hearing. So faith comes by hearing. So faith comes by hearing.
Yes.
And hearing by the word of God.
Yes.
If you want faith, you got to get into his word.
Yes.
You got to get into his word. You got to put the word on the inside of you. You got to live by faith. You got to walk by faith.
Yes.
Our faith will be tested.
Yes.
Our faith will be tested.
Yes.
Innocent blood for a guilty world.
Uh-huh.
He was without sin. He died for you.
Yes.
He died for me. Yes. No greater love. No greater love. No greater love. You need to develop a personal relationship with Christ.
Amen.
It's all about today, not tomorrow. Tomorrow's not promised to you. Today is the day. I went to homeboy services last week. People are leaving here. People are leaving here. Get your ticket. God loves you. He died for you. And he wants you to be with him. For Christ I'll live. For Christ I'll die. No greater love. God bless you.